a fish market with no fish, and even in the empty streets, the doors are closed against them. Elbowed from their own streets, people here die, or they wake one day and just leave everything, so many things behind them, and behind them, all the doors are closed. But when the road stops, it is always open water, and they can't walk there. Not many, anyway. Maybe one. I walk in a streak of blue, a state of grace, like a sign, like direction, like my reflection. Is it a tattoo, they ask, because this blue is a part of me, not a piece, but a part, not a part from me. Is it a tattoo, they ask? He asks, wide smile. No, it's paint. And smile twists teeth into stare, grimace, knowing you've been hurt. His eyes are water. You've been hurt, yes, yes. Hand in hand, he tells me, be well, girl, be well. And hands broken, he leaves with all his things for sale. He just smiles as he tears a life into pieces, arranged by type, by material, because it's cheaper that way. Bruno is the oldest remover of things in Venice, a child of the islands, a child of Scarborough, not the fish. The evacuation. His father fled one war and he was born in the center of another. 1941. Clang. Wood meets metal. Clang. Clang. One mattress. Clang. Three rugs. Clang. Seven wooden planks and a dog named Lucky. Clang. And one old man with strong fingers that can tear. Clang. Almost anything. Clang into pieces. On a boat too large to travel in the sunshine, so it only moves at night. Clang. For the shells we leave behind, and this city will slowly empty, one Venetian at a time, and Bruno will come. Clang. With his luck on board to carry the remains away, away, away in a streak of blue. Clang. Away from closed doors. Clang. Away, away, away to open water. Plan, plan, plan.